still buy?
Yeah, dude. I used to. I'll buy shit on you.
This is a heavy weight.
Yeah.
Some of these I don't have unlocked. So.
Oh, we got doors for me.
Oh shit. It is a, overall an 84?
Yeah. This one, man. Go crazy.
Go crazy. Yeah, that's a cool dude too.
Opening 3 minutes of this 10th round fight.
Need to keep that head moving.
Teddy, what a thrill it is for us to be seated ringside tonight for this. Oh. Mike Tyson, Joe Frazier, two trains colliding.
Yeah, two trains, and one is a little bit bigger than the other train. Tyson a little bit bigger, a little bit faster, and you worry a little bit if you're back on Frazier, if he can handle, at least early on, that size, that strength, that speed.
Oh, I missed that right.
Let's get this fight over with.
He's too fast.
That's how he fought in real life.
Now he's fighting Jake Paul.
Yeah.
He said he
right hand over the top, very accurate with it.
You know that?
Took a shot, now he gives a left. Halfway through this round, Frazier's jab lands well. Turns over that hook and he does damage upstairs. Frazier's got to deal with a cut sheet.
Ooh, that nigga Mike Tyson cut that nigga already.
Flush right hand to the head. Took a shot, now he gives a left. Mike Tyson
Ooh.
By a right hand. Solid. That shot crashes. He crashes to the canvas.
Fire.
He gets sent to the canvas.
I got sent to the green flag.
Oh, yeah, I'm good at getting up.
I'm
only bad when you
can't
get up
here today. Good block.
Joe Frazier got power. I forgot.
Now he ties up there. And now committing to that midsection as the target with the combination punching. Final 10 seconds of round number one.
Get out of the way for those punches! Move your head!
End of the round. A round in which a knockdown was scored. Now, Teddy, if you're the trainer in the corner of the guy scoring the knockdown, what are some of the things you want to remind him of?
You want to remind them how he got there, because a lot of times it's the tendency to just remember the punch that put him there. He dressed him up. He set that punch up. Don't think about just the punch that landed. Think about the setup punches.
Tyson's not putting forth much offense at all. Now listen, I get it. You put forth some offense, you got hurt, you were stunned in this fight, so now you're strictly thinking defense. But at some point, he's got to change.
Yeah, he does. Otherwise, he can't win this fight. And his opponent is just going to keep coming like that ocean, banging into that shore, and it's going to come further up the shoreline. It's not going to go away.
Good return fire that time. You see him with the left of the head there? Joe Frazier in action here. Of course, most notable action of his career came on March 8th of 1971. The fight comes.
Oh, damn.
He just went down. The infighter went out, and Now he went down.
Hey, it's okay to go out, but go out the side door. He went out the front door, and as you said, maybe paid the ultimate price.
Ooh! That was a nice one. I thought I was going to hit your ass. You fast.
Not able to land the uppercut.
Yup. You seen that?
Switch stances.
Down. Wait, no, left.
Left stick?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But Joe Frazier wasn't a southpaw. That's gonna be bad for you.
Targeted double jab by Joe Frazier.
Oh, we both swing and a miss.
Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. You see what happens when he commits to the uppercut? Look at that. Great work there. Just 10 seconds to go in this round.
I tried it. Yeah, I tried to throw it
away. You see that? Now heads back to his corner. Teddy, do you ever have to calm a guy down after
look at your eye.
That's a really great point. Because a lot of times, but not for your guy that scored the knockdown for the other guy. Because sometimes when you score a knockdown, you start to think it's going to be an easy night. And you forget what you knew when you came in. That wasn't going to be an easy night. You're going to have to bring all the tools out of the tool set. And it's important. Remember that.
Frazier's trying to steady him.
I think that's my, yeah.
Previous round. Teddy, how much can really happen in those 60 seconds? How much of a benefit is it to a damaged fighter?
Well, a lot has to happen. First of all, physically, you have to reinvigorate the guy. You know, maybe massage the legs a little bit. Most importantly, get some ice on the back of his neck. You know, get that blood flow going a little bit. Make sure that you revive him a little bit. Get him back to feeling like he's ready to go out there.
That's an impactful right hand by Joe Frazier. What impact from that uppercut by Joe Frazier. Coming to the halfway point of this third round, Joe Frazier's got to deal with a cut on his cheek right now. The good news is it's below the eye, but still, it can get nasty as the fight progresses.
Damn.
Tyson's punch is far off the target.
We're missing.
Scoring well with that combination by Mike Tyson. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Joe Frazier. Frazier smacked up top. Good, strong uppercut. He comes right back with it after taking one.
Damn. Come on, Frazier.
Frazier's blocking ability is doing well for him there. More than one punch downstairs, that can be damaging. Big, big shot to work with. Moselle said it best. Down goes Frazier.
That blood getting
everywhere.
Unfortunately
for Smokin' Joe, it's not the first time he's heard that tonight.
Three.
Maybe you gotta balance the top one and then rise with the this one, yeah.
Good fun entertainment. If you're a broadcaster, if you're in these two corners, you're probably sweating now as they've traded knockdowns. Now you do have him up 2-1 though as we start round number 4, Teddy.
Yeah, I mean, I think that he served himself a little bit. He learned something from that knockdown. He's been a little more cautious, but he's still being the boss, still controlling things.
With a flush left hook to the body and then that right hand. Joe Frazier showing us some of those survival tactics that he's picked up as a pro. Was knocked down earlier and now he's in survival mode.
And that's exactly where he needs to be if he wants to get to another round and if he wants to be able to turn it around, get offensive later.
Ooh, shit.
He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Joe Frazier. Gotta be accurate to send the combination to the body, and he does that. Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Halfway through round number 4. Tyson. Tyson with a powerful left hand. Well, something's got to stick. He sends the combination to the body. He missed with that headshot. Trying to score up top, but off the mark there. Joe Frazier reminds me of one of those cartoons right now with Bernie.
You got saved by the
bell. He needs to get rid of those cobwebs and find a way to stay in this fight.
That's crazy.
No way.
I ain't never seen Joe Frazier.
I don't
want to
see you on the outside, man. Okay? This fight.
So a fresh round is underway. But is it a fresh fighter?
That shit quit,
Frazier's corner is hoping so. Based on what we saw at the end of the last round, who knows?
Well, his corner should also be hoping that his opponent across the way doesn't come out here like the executioner to get this over with. Because if he does, I think it's over.
Not able to land the headshot. Well, his opponent is opening up and coming forward. So
I think there's some counterpunching opportunities. Opportunities not on the front end, but on the back end.
Really wanted that big shot there. Oh, that's a big shot. Frazier's hurt. He's down and hurt. Can he beat the count?
Right now, he's thinking about another line of employment.
Two.
Building up a lot of momentum. Be careful.
Four.
Balance that shit.
Five. Six.
He can still get up.
Nine,
yeah.
Ten.
Yeah, he does.
It's because of his stamina.
And it's all over.
I get butterbean and you get somebody good.
Power surge here. Knockout winner.
I get somebody trash.
Mike Tyson's power that we saw throughout the night building a lead on your scorecard. Mark there going upstairs. And just grabbing on onto his opponent.
Yeah, if you press both, you grab by pressing both of the bumpers.
Fire it right back with one of his own. Good work by Evander Holyfield.
Damn, you stopped my heart attack.
Halfway through round number one.
Ooh, damn.
Teddy, we've seen both these guys before, and we have a feeling, just kind of have the feeling that it could be one of those special nights.
Yeah, because their styles, it suits up for one of those special nights.
Couldn't hit the elusive target with that straight right. Matchup tonight, power puncher against a guy who's well conditioned. Now, early on, what do you look for in a matchup like that?
You want to make sure that if you're with the power puncher, you don't go out there chasing after the guy. You use all your tools. You use your jab, and you control him. You make him think about your power so he can't control rounds.
Gets rid of that effort.
Hey,
final 10 seconds. Evander Holyfield's right hand working well that time. He scored well. Now this round is over, and now a little bit of time for the corner to try to get some defensive sense left into the man.
You know, don't. It's too late for that time. That time came in the gym. He had to be taught that before he ever got here. He's going to have to live or die for what he knows right now.
Good scoring shot. It's a straight right. To the head he goes with a left hand. Evander Holyfield's hurt from that. Trying to erode away that body with the combination punching. Teddy, early on here, you cannot stress enough how much good comes from going to the body.
And you can't stress how many times you heard your parents tell you as a kid, put that change into the piggy bank, because it's gonna add up. Well, body punches add up.
Scored well upstairs
with
the right
hand. That's how you do uppercuts, yeah.
And right from the start, he's throwing the power punches and landing them.
I think he has a thing he wants to get through.
And then,
straight. Yeah,
I guess you didn't know how to play. I thought you knew how to play.
Tried to land that upstairs and was off the
there
mark.
You go, yeah. God damn.
There's that overhand right. Butterbean's just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. Count down the final moments of this round. End of the round there. He was able to stun his opponent. Teddy, when you're training a guy that's coming off a round where he just got to his man, what do you do? Do you say, hey, I saw that, and here's how you did it? How do you approach that?
Well, you want to make sure you remind them exactly what you're talking about, how you set it up. Don't think about just a big punch to
the local. And the ref's going to warn him. He's got to get him up. And the ref looks at him and says, no headbutting. Hands out the warning. Off to the side. A little swing and a miss going upstairs. He clinches when he gets to the inside. There he goes with the right hand again. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Overhand right can be so effective. Where's the body? Butterbean's movement helped out there. He avoided that punch. He returns the favor with an uppercut. fires right back at him. Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself. Clean shot with the right. Holyfield's not going to get away with this here. That headbutt the referee is saying.
You know why you get away with it? Because he right. Well, when you do it, you got to get penalized.
God damn. That's fucked up.
The round comes to an end. Butterbean is crazy, all right?
Don't get lazy. Win this fight.
Three rounds in the books. Butterbean's in control. Teddy, he's up with a clean sweep on your scorecard.
Yeah, and I like the way he's doing it. You know, he's making the guy come to him. He's making him miss and he's scoring all the clean punches.
A fan of Holyfield's the target of a hook. Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with him.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time him, he can counter him.
Holyfield showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. Lock in that target and bring it home well.
One or two more of those, it'll be the end of the night.
Evander Holyfield's coming through now beautifully. That's the combination punching he wants to put forth. Holyfield with a huge left.
Finish with the
hug. Well, supposed to be fighting, but instead he's hugging. Double jab right to the face. And now just wasting away some time with that clinch. Double jab by Evander Holyfield. Failure to protect himself from that left hand, it's become a big story now.
Yeah, and he has to understand why. He's not controlling distance. He's standing just a little further out.
This stamina at 77. This is bad for Butterbean.
Round number five has arrived. Holyfield's last round, and he could be a turning point kind of round. I mean, you start this round right here, and you do have the sense, even though I think he's down on the scorecards, you do have the sense that he's headed in the right direction.
Well, good things can start, you know, one step at a time. Oh, he took that first step. Now he's going to take the second step and put two good rounds in a row together.
Evander Holyfield showing that he's got some defense. That's a big right hand there. Oh, he's hurt right there. He is hurt. Oh! He goes down! Now he's got to beat the count of 10.
Oh, that's what you got to end it.
Get up, dude!
1, 2
Hey, I'm up! Goddamn, nigga.
Butterbean's back up, but is he back in the fight?
We're going to find out in a second whether or not he moves his head. Now, if he just stands there straight and you're the trainer, you better get up on those steps and stop him. He's not
Don't
right.
Don't you ever punch me like that anymore.
And now he's acting like a fighter. Coming back with the right hand after getting scored upon.
What a beast, man.
That is
Punch
101. A nice...
Butterbeans.
finishing is working well here. This is just beautiful to watch. Watch how he just links one to the next, Teddy. A beautiful sequence, almost like musical notes being played.
Well, exactly. It's a nice tune because it just follows. One, as you said, follows the other. Nice and smooth.
Gone by in this round. Butterbean's just doing what he's been doing all night long. We've seen it throughout. He's been scoring well on the inside. He's been hitting those headshots. I don't know what the answer is on the other side, Teddy, but there's got to be something they can do different.
Well, one thing is he has to notice that, yeah, he's staying on the outside, but he's pulling back straight every once in a while. So what you got to do is make believe you're an NFL quarterback. Everybody wanted to be an NFL quarterback. You know, where you lead the receiver. So what you do is you anticipate that he's going to go back and you aim a punch behind him. Let him walk right into that punch. Let him pull into that punch.
Back up top he goes. And now he's targeting upstairs. Good fighting, snapping shot by Evander Holyfield. Halfway through round six, and he's holding. Holyfield finding out right now that this counter-punching style is not getting the results he needs in these middle rounds. What is the answer?
Well, when a guy's not coming in and walking in, you can't counterpunch. I mean, he's not giving you the kind of turf that you need. Now you have to find a way to create your offense, to lead a little bit. That starts with the jab, getting off first.
He just missed that shot up top. Jab right hand. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left-hand score. What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Evander Holyfield. Working our way towards the bell. Last 10 seconds of the sixth. Crashes home with the uppercut. And round six comes to an end. Evander Holyfield's plan was not supposed to be this result that we're getting here. Now it's later in the fight, and his opponent is still able to score with ease out of range.
Well, his corner has to think about doing something drastic. He's taking all these shots. This fight is in danger of being stopped. He's definitely going to lose it anyway. Maybe do something I tried years ago with Mills Lane. Believe it or not, bring him over to the corner, use him a little bit, use the referee, bring him over to the corner and say, listen, if he doesn't change, I want you stopping this fight the next round. This way you put your fighter on notice what's going on.
What's that?
Chest to chest and the combination punching scores. Butterbean's a slugger. There's no other way to describe him but that. But that style is a perfect fit for this fight. He's winning these middle rounds.
Yeah, he loves this. This is a PS6 brawl, and he's very comfortable in that kind of bout.
Halfway through the seventh round. Nice job doubling up the jab by Evander Holyfield. Oh, that uppercut got him badly. Wow! How is he gonna survive this? Once again, he hits the deck.
He's gonna have to find a way.
That would have been too bad. This is horrible.
One.
Oh my God.
Two. Three. Four. Five.
Oh shit.
Six.
Get up.
Seven. Eight.
Better than eight.
Hard to prepare for a situation like this, but many do. He's been down, now he's got to survive.
So that's where you want. It's not hard to prepare, it's a must to prepare. If you're a trainer, that's what you do in the gym. You teach a guy, if you're in this situation, this is what you do. You grab on, you move your head, you survive.
Man, the Holyfield way too fast.
Puts forth the hook, scores with it. Look at the actors shoot that hook upstairs. Targeting that midsection now with the combo. Missed the target with that hook. Butterbean's doing really well on the outside, utilizing his jab. slight lead here, but I'll say this. He may be up on your scorecards, but his opponent knows how to land a punch against him.
Yeah, he's found the home for that right hand. He notices that he brings that left hand back slow, so the right hand beats him to the ball.
Butterbean's giving me a sense that he really doesn't want to have the fight the way it was. He was stunned earlier, and now just so much more defense we're seeing out of him.
Well, right now, what I think he has to do is try to get an Oscar. Get that award that those great actors get, and not show that he's defensive right now, because if he shows that too much, his opponent is going to know what he has to do to take advantage.
Holyfield proving to be elusive.
Double up the punch!
Commits to the overhand right, and it serves him well. Butterbean's so dangerous with that accuracy and two-punch combination landing. Tried the hook, didn't get it. Evander Holyfield with a big right hand. Good flush shot upstairs. Hits him in the mug with the right. Butterbean's left now getting into the mix. Nice combination there. Here's a moment here as you see the step back counter punch where you realize this is the sweet science, not just some raw savagery switch out.
Look at the little subtleties here, Joe. What he does is he forces him into a position to stop the punch. And then when he stops, steps back, makes the miss, and comes right back.
Blocked by Holyfield. And that's the end of round eight. Now, Butterbean's going to have to deal with a cut here. You can see that they're already working on it. But what's the one message you got to get across to your fighter when he's cut?
Well, the first thing you got to do is have his trust. You gotta tell him, look, we'll do our job, you do your job. Go out there, act like a flow. This was always in the making. This was always in the script. That to be a champion, sooner or later, you're gonna have to pass a test. This is your test. Go out there, act like you don't have a cut. Let us take care of that job. The right coagulants. You have to be calm. You have to be able to put pressure on that cut, get it to stop, and then put those medicines in. But you need a little help from the fighter.
Oh!
On his bike and give those medicines time to work.
Final round. Who wants it more? Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. A crush, big shot. Down again! Unreal!
Damn. Now you gotta wonder what the corner's thinking. Are they gonna stop this?
Get up! Get up! 3, 4, get up! Five, get up! Get up! 6, 7, 8, focus!
How is he up?
I'm good at getting up.
But he's gonna continue on, beating the count. Holyfield's got a shore up that defense. You cannot get hit with back-to-back hooks upstairs. Evander Holyfield's on the bad end of a big hook upstairs. Lands flush with the two-punch combo.
Oh,
and
shit.
All of a sudden, the tables turn. Evander Holyfield's rocked.
What's good for you?
Stop punching.
Oh, wow, Teddy, he's got some great hand speed there. That combination was an example.
Yeah, it was. You know, not a lot of power, not a lot of pop with it, but boy, it catches your attention. And you know what? That kind of speed can intimidate a guy and keep his opponent maybe from moving his hands later on.
Teddy, he may go down just by stumbling the way he's bubbling around this ring. He is not in good shape. He could be on the deck in moments. Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Damn,
damn
it.
Clutch. Like a sack of potatoes.
I mean, clinch.
He said, he went down like a sack of potatoes.
One, two,
hell.
Three.
He won't get the fuck
four,
up.
Get up. Six, seven, eight. Let's go. Nine, 10.
Bro, I knocked him out.
Come on, get to your feet.
Evander Holyfield's opponent is floored.
Hey, Butterfield fought a good fight, man. He's just not good. He's not having that good.
Evander Holyfield's knockout here.
I was close,
though.
This I was 1 point
was
behind.
Clearly going to go the.
Face Ali. One is, how do you land it? You have to find the perfect spot. Maybe catch him, pull him back with his hands down. You know, maybe time him as he's throwing a jab. But very difficult to do. And then the second problem, you have a guy that you're hitting that has a great chin.
Parries that punch intended for the head. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Gracie's defense did a good job there, able to avoid that punch. And coming upon the halfway mark of this three-minute round, blocks the headshot. Not one, but two. Good work with the jab up top. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Did you see that?
Ow.
You know, when you bully the bully, you can do that right there.
Tyson
floored by the power punch.
Damn.
One, two.
Oh, I see you clear the first try. He ugly as fuck.
Tyson's climb back up from the canvas may inspire him. Unable to make an impact there by Mike Tyson.
Yeah, he's 6'3", I believe.
Damn. Oh, shot blocked.
Ow.
He caught you on the other side of the football field.
Back upstairs he goes. Ali blocks it. This round, alongside Kenny Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Now they got some work to do here. The man was just dropped.
Yeah, the first thing is you put some cold water, you can't use that, you clear his head, and you tell him why he was dropped.
Nice work with the combination by Muhammad Ali.
Oh, shit. Come on, lady. Come on, baby.
Just not there, straight right hand off the mark. Tyson's out there for another round after being knocked down in the last round. We know what happens in the 60 seconds with a fighter who was damaged, but what about those 60 seconds in the opposing corner, Teddy?
You know, Joe, that's a great question. And I remember my mentor, Customato, when we were training fighters, he used to always say, look, you know you're a banger, and this guy happens to be a banger.
Like,
well, if you hit a guy clean,
that?
You know you hurt him.
Yeah.
But he's not going to show you. He's going to act like a pro. He's going to con you. He's going to act like that didn't hurt him. But you have to remember, hey, it hurt him. So go after him like he showed you, even if he's not showing it.
A huge right hand from Mike Tyson. Well, he's trying to keep up a heck of a work rate here. Tyson's punching himself out at this point.
Yeah, and that's not the worst part of it. The worst part of it is going to be if his opponent notices.
Good right hand. There's the combo downstairs. Final 10 seconds of round number two. Two snapping jabs by Mike Tyson. Muhammad Ali back to his corner.
Hey, man, close up that cut on my chin. Look at my daddy.
You know, with Ali,
close up
that fucking
cut on Mike
Tyson. It's about all those kind of tangible things that you look at, they just light
up.
But now it's about something else. On the inside, how does he react being cut?
I can't let you open that shit back up.
Trying to bank away body shots with the combo.
Oh, shit. Mike Tyson is so strong. Yeah.
Over the years, especially in the heavyweight division, there have been some guys that can throw a good right uppercut. But when Tyson fully dips and gets all that body behind it, it's as good a right uppercut as we've ever seen.
Yeah, it's coming from Brooklyn. You know, it's coming from a place that really you wish that you didn't have to visit because you get hit with that punch. He's putting everything into it, but he sets it up nice. He hits you behind the back a little bit in the rib area, and then all of a sudden, when your arm moves a little bit, it's coming up the middle.
Muhammad Ali blocks that punch. Another flush shot lands upstairs. Locks that belt line well.
Damn.
Wow, what an uppercut. Good step back, counter punch there.
Beautiful.
The old 1-2 scores for him. Last 10 seconds.
Ooh! I tried to do it.
Good job!
I tried to do it.
Nick, come on, your head for us.
We open up round number 4 here. Let's look at Teddy's scorecard, where he's up 2-1. I like his work rate, Teddy.
You know, he's not landing all the time. Clean, but it reminds me a little bit of some of the old fans used to say to me, Teddy, Marciano, we love Marciano. You know, the Rock. He used to hit guys on his arms. He wasn't hitting them clean, but he was breaking their blood vessels. Excuse me for being so graphic, but he was breaking their blood vessels, and they couldn't get their arms up by the time they got to the 8th, 9th, 10th round. That's kind of the way this guy fights.
Teddy, what would you recommend based on what we're seeing here tonight?
Well, 2 aspirin and then, oh no, actually, I would say a little counterpunching would be just what the doctor ordered.
That's a better prescription for him.
How is he not?
Nice solid left hand scored by Mike Tyson.
Oh, shit. Bam! Ooh!
Wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Oh, he just misses with that headshot.
Damn. He can't be so tall.
You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. 10 seconds to go in the 4th. Ali's approach to these remaining rounds is going to be critical. I think you do that he's trailing on the scorecards, but I also think that he's capable of turning things around.
Well, right now it's so close, it's going to come down to the inside, I believe. Whoever does not make those solid agreements, doesn't sign their name to the contract, you know, you get a little tired, it gets a little tough, you put your hands behind the guy, you hope the guy grabs and he goes along with it. Whoever doesn't go along with that, whoever brings their hands back and throws those punches, those 2, those 3, those 4 extra punches, they're going to win the fight.
Tyson's right hand scores well. Able to block that away, it was targeted for his head. A classic 1-2 combo by Mike Tyson.
Mike Tyson, Muhammad Ali, big ass, no, he know how to move. He dancing on you. And he tall too.
Still plenty of time to work here in round number 5. 1.5 minutes to go. Tyson's doing what every trainer wants to see their fighter do. Land punches and punches. The combination lands. 5. Muhammad Ali's making for a tough target there. He gets away from that punch.
You're
not supposed to say.
Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. A well-placed left hand up top. Ali's knowledge of the game is showing through. 3 ways to defend. 1 of them is to block. He did it there well. Coming to the end of round number 5. Last 10 seconds. comes to an end. Ali's all of a sudden finding his stride here. In that last round, we saw vast improvement. He's still down on your scorecard, right, Teddy?
Yeah, he has him down a little bit.
But he's making a comeback here based on what we just saw.
He's doing what he needs to do. You know, he's picking up the pace a little bit, and he's starting to get into the right range. To me, before, he's too far back. Now he's taking the steps to put himself in a position where he can start doing the things he needs to do to get back in his fight.
Good job on the two-punch combo by Muhammad Ali. Able to get rid of that one.
Sweep your head.
Blocks away that headshot. Tyson swinging and missing like he's at bat right there. That punch was nowhere near his opponent. Reaching the halfway point of round number six. Double jab by Mike Tyson.
You open up that cut again, I'm bleeding on my shorts.
Nice block that time. It was intended to the head. Combination, you're really hitting your groove. Final 10 seconds of the sixth round.
I'm tired, Tyson.
Protecting his head well with his guard. Well, as that round comes to an end, it gives us a moment to reflect on this overall fight. Teddy, my thoughts are pretty clear cut. This is the kind of fight that just takes on a personality of its own. This is an all-out war.
Yeah, this is kind of like
this is not good.
On the budget. You know, he's spending with both hands. You know, when
this
he
is
goes
not
home,
good.
He's gonna have no money in his pocket.
Like,
and when this fight is over,
like
these guys are gonna have nothing left in the like gas tank, and it's probably not going to a decision.
Well, Sakura from fucking Naruto.
Is not what he was looking for. That's a miss. That's a huge left he just scored with.
But now the question is whether or not his opponent has found something that will work.
All
found something
game,
that will get those legs unsteady once again.
Damn. You just missed that shit.
At the halfway point of round seven. One, two jabs up top. And now we got a fight. He fires back a right hand of his own.
Sir, why are you taunting?
Ali's able to avoid that punch. And he just holds on there.
I don't want no tired dude stinking nigga on me. I'm light skinned. I don't want no fucking black nigga on me. You're tired ass. Yo, so your ass so slow, you can't even bite off my ear this time.
That is exactly what the corner wanted to see. A good combination punch by Mike Tyson.
Damn!
10 seconds to go in the seventh.
You missed it, the motherfucker.
And that's the end of round seven.
Yo, he probably at 80 now.
I want you to double.
Yeah,
good close fight here, but momentum is starting to build in one direction. Teddy, he's enjoying a slight lead on your scorecard.
Yeah, and early on, we were eavesdropping a little bit. The corner's been telling him things. They could have gave this lead a little earlier, but he wasn't listening. Now they're starting to sink in a little bit, and it takes time with a fighter because you're under such pressure. It doesn't get to you right away. You start to understand as it goes on.
Look at Muhammad Ali and his ability to avoid punches here. He's got it every which way. He's slick, he's smooth, he blocks and parries, good defense. Really good job by Ali. Scores with the combo to the head. He missed with that headshot. Mike Tyson's missing punches here. Now, the good news is he's throwing punches, but Teddy needs to be more accurate.
Okay, I'll give you the bad news.
Please.
He's throwing them to the wrong place. He's throwing him upstairs. He should throw him downstairs. This guy's moving his head. You go downstairs, you take away that head movement. Then you find him upstairs.
Nice 1-2 by Muhammad Ali. Momentum is now on his side.
That's why you can't let go of that steering wheel when you're driving. You know, all of a sudden, bang, you're in the back seat. You're not in the front seat. You're not in the driver's seat anymore.
Ali's gathering himself right now in the corner. And his trainer is really doing him a good service in reminding him. Yes, at this point, the later stages of this fight, you're in control. But still, go out and do everything we talked about in training game.
I don't understand that.
Tyson's recovered nicely here. The start of this round, and he is proving to me at least that what happened in that last round is having no effect on this round. Two snapping jabs by Mike Tyson.
Keep doing what you're doing.
Good way to protect the midsection. Ali showing us that defense is also very much part of his game.
Yeah, it is. Not only to avoid punches, but actually to even set up offense. You know, he'll make you miss, and then there's something coming back. He creates opportunities to hit you.
Kick move! Kick move!
Focus! Ali's coming up with the answers, avoiding that punch. 90 seconds into the ninth round.
He sound like a train.
He's so tired.
Tyson's punch didn't come close. Two-punch combo by Mike Tyson. Final chance, last 10 seconds of round 9. Ali's going with a quality that I think is very underrated in boxing. That is to be judicious, to really think about when, how, and make the most of each thing you're doing. His punch rate, very, very effective in terms of his... And yet another big shot comes in. Well, we know he survived earlier, but now he goes down for a second time.
One, two, three, four, five,
seven. Oh.
Tyson's unable to beat the count. Knockout loss for him. Now that's it. Yes, he was controlling throughout, but he made a good clean finish.
I had it.
Yeah, it's a tragedy.
And then he just fell down.
You love that shit, Slay. Go three times.
Underway. Scheduled for two rounds.
That's between getting up and slamming on the pavement.
No. Well, we've been waiting all week to call this one. Take what kind of fighter you expect?
Oh, the kind of guys that they get insulted if you miss them, Joe.
I'm going to show you.
Muhammad Ali can be so elusive, but Teddy, when he has been hit by power, he's got a great chin.
Yeah, that's the problem that's discouraging. First of all, the first thing is the speed, the elusive ability. How do you catch him clean? And then, as you just said, you finally catch him, and it's like hitting something that doesn't give. Something that absorbs greatly.
Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head.
Why is this not working? Pressing both pumps at the same time.
Halfway through this round here.
Three times this round. He ain't hit you none. You heard the man in the crowd go,
nice! Nice strike after catching one by Muhammad Ali.
Double up your chin.
All right. 5 hits, 6 hits.
Damn.
10 seconds to go in this round. Fundamentally sound hook right there, and it served him well. Round comes to an end, and it just boggles the mind time and time. We sit here ringside, and we watch guys who waste time. They're out there just going through the motions, not firing off punches.
Hey, if you don't move your hands, you don't throw punches, it's hard to win rounds.
Punches together now. That's a nice combination.
I'm weaving them bitches. That's why. Whenever you weave, you miss it.
Teddy, we have found out time and time again in boxing that you are very much a product of where you come from. How is that the case with Mike Tyson?
Well, it's a case where a lot of people maybe don't even see that, but they see that he's big, he's strong, he's a monster. He's Godzilla. They think he's Godzilla. But they don't see is where he came from. When he was a kid, he used to hide in abandoned buildings, hide in between walls. Sometimes I wonder if he ever got out from behind those walls. Sometimes I think there's a part of him that is still hiding in those walls.
Not able to land the headshot.
Because I'm leaving.
Landing two jabs by Mike Tyson.
Depending on the strike you throw, which way I go, it'll go right across.
Takes one, but gets one. Good work by Muhammad Ali.
All right. You are dominating this fight. Keep it up. Just keep doing what you're doing.
Three is underway. Dismisses his opponent's
headshot.
Yeah, right. Hook off the jab.
Muhammad Ali's nailed by a huge. the right hand. Mike Tyson's strategy has been to control things on the outside, and the jab fits perfectly into it.
Yeah, what he's done is he's set up his defense, he's kept his opponent defensive, kept him off balance, off stride, and he's also set up his power shots whenever he's wanted to.
Scores well, a three-punch combo by Mike Tyson. Reaching the halfway mark of this round.
Keep moving, keep moving!
I should have been here.
And you can see he wanted to do that as he holds on there.
You're not focusing!
Not getting it done with that straight right hand. Tyson's combination punching here is showing you what good boxing is all about. Three punches thrown, three punches landed.
Yeah, not a lot of damage going on, like, but as you just said, one guy working, the other guy's not.
Ali's not throwing the power punches, Teddy. What would you say to him?
Well, first of all, I would say to him, what do you think, that he's going to make a deal with you? If you don't hit him hard, he won't hit you hard? No, no, it doesn't work like that, my friend. He's going to get confidence now. He's going to take advantage of this.
What an excellent two-punch combo by Muhammad Ali. Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs.
Double up, move your hand.
90 seconds to go in round number four. Good 1-2 by Muhammad Ali. Little head hunting with the left. Now he's putting his punches together, the combination upstairs.
Damn. Where's my lunge?
Keep working the job.
By Mike Tyson. Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark.
Nice! Nice!
He took a shot, but he came back with a right hand of his own.
Two jabs. Every time you throw that jab, I want to see you land that overhand, right? Don't go straight in.
They start up again. Back to action here with another round. But who knows how much longer it'll last. This has been a completely one-sided fight. Little head knocking with that right hand. Mike Tyson's rocked by that punch. Oh, he's hurt right there. He is hurt.
So this kind of situation, it's kind of like a wounded animal.
And banging away he goes, and he goes down. It was a magnificent combination that put him down.
Now he has to get up.
Fuck Mike Tyson up. He might just bust through this door and knock you out. If he do that, I can't help
Mike
you. I got my good enough.
Respond to that. He's been knocked down, and now he rises up. Another flush shot up top.
Thank you.
outside. A little swing and a miss going upstairs. Tyson's doing well here with that two-punch combination. He just gave his opponent a really good taste of how fast his hand speed is.
Yeah, you know, a lot of times we talk about power, and we see that power, you know, can damage a guy right away, obviously, and it can intimidate an opponent. But hand speed can do the same thing, and I think it's intimidating right now to his opponent. He's afraid to let that jab go because he might get countered with one of those lightning right hands.
Ali's showing that walking stick right now, utilizing the jab. So he scores a knockdown in the last round. Now he gets to settle down and gather himself. Do you go after it? Do you get super aggressive? Or do you still have to employ a certain amount of caution? Right.
Kind of like being at the carnival, you know, you just hit the bullseye and you got that big stuffed animal you can give to your wife or your girlfriend. But now he doesn't want you to go away with that.
Oh no.
He tells you, wait a minute, try again. You could trade that in for something either bigger, but you might lose the one you have already. That's the question.
Good double jab by Mike Tyson. Tyson's like a piece of Velcro against his opponent recently here. It seems like he's clinching more after that knockdown.
Yeah, that's exactly what he has to do right now. Now he has to be able to just get...
Oh, there you go! Of course, Mike Tyson has a history with being down, but not necessarily out. Will this be like the first knockdown against Buster Douglas or the final one?
Three, four, five, six, seven.
Keep this one up, but balance this one.
So many people point to the downfall of Mike Tyson, but few remember how he would get up off the canvas time and time again in some of those toughest fights. 90 seconds to go here in this round. Mike Tyson's combination punching is just perfect there. Three punches landing.
Keep moving, keep moving.
Just missed that shot up top. Ali's hitting the mark right now. How precise. Mike Tyson stung by a big shot. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Muhammad Ali.
Let
it
go.
Now Tyson looks to have his feet back underneath him.
Yeah, but does he have his mind right? Is he still going to be the seek and destroy fighter that he's been before?
Mike Tyson's banged up by a left hand. Ali's showing some real guts here. Hey, this fight was not going his way at all, but somehow he has gathered momentum.
I'm at 100.
He's got some tough times.
Right now, he had 100,
good
bro.
Times in front of him.
Box intelligently for me.
All right,
come on. More intelligent.
But you don't got no damage either.
Let's go.
Yeah, he get tired.
Start of a new round, but will it be much the same? Tyson's been down numerous times tonight, Teddy.
Well, if there was a mercy rule like there is in Little League Baseball, guess what? It would be in bulk right now, and this would be over.
Turn the sender with the left hand.
I said, come on, baby. You ain't gonna get none of that if you lose.
Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Good job. It was sudden, it was fast, it was direct by Muhammad Ali.
Come on.
Yeah, I don't know why those didn't hit. That's crazy.
Like, I get you backed away, but you should have at least came back to at least hit your chest or something.
Come on! Keep it going!
Keep moving! Keep moving!
Muhammad Ali's movements really Tyson's not looking good at all. Was knocked down earlier. Clearly the damage is getting to him. I don't know how much more of this he can take, Ted.
Well, they don't allow smelling salts. That's not legal. If they allow smelling salts, they take some.
Wow, nice flush left hand. He's punching away, even though he's been stunned. Landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. And round seven comes to an end.
You know what's going to happen now, right?
Start of round number eight here. Let's look at Teddy's scorecard. As you can see, Tyson's up on Teddy's scorecard. He's been applying a good amount of pressure, and many times, you get a close competitive fight like this, you're always gonna give the lean to the guy who's working more.
Yeah, he's keeping it defensive. You know, his offense is also working as his defense because, yeah, we're saying that he's ahead because he's working more, as you just said, and you said properly. But
he's
working. There's a reason why. Because this guy's working more. He's keeping him defensive, by the way.
Come on. Don't give me that hit, please.
Combination to the head. Tyson's in there clinching a lot, it seems to me. I mean, he was stunned earlier, but it just seems like he's tying up.
Hey, if it seems like that to you, that's okay. But more importantly, more dangerously for him, it probably seems that way to his opponent, and he's going to take advantage of it. He knows that he's not right.
The halfway point of round number eight.
Good job. I mean, good job. Like, it's over.
Keep moving. Mike Tyson's missing the mark by a mile. That just was nowhere to be found. Much action as he just ties up.
Keep moving.
Yeah, even when he's walking.
Last 10 seconds of the eighth round. Ali was able to get to his man in that last round. Now he's got some momentum.
You know, everyone thinks he's not a puncher, but he puts them together. And he put those punches together where he got the effect he wanted.
You can see him timing that double jab to the head. Mike Tyson's tag! He tried to nab up top, but was unable to connect. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault.
Oh,
as we welcome you to the Mexico City Plaza here in Mexico City for tonight's main event. 10 rounds in the heavyweight division. Boy, and we expect this to be a big night of action. We spoke with both fighters yesterday. Fireworks anticipated here tonight. Let's see. Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. Very nice work to the head. The right hand landed. You know, we only show up when it's time to watch them do their thing for the fight, but they're really working at it day in and day out just to make weight. What's so tough about making weight in boxing?
Well, it can weigh you down. I mean, it takes discipline. And all of a sudden, it allows you a trail of excuses, because now you can start to say, well, gee, you know, I didn't do this. You know, it's the drudgery of it, and it's the consistency of it. When you have to stay at a weight, you have to watch that weight, you have to balance it where you're also going to be able to have a physicality when you get in the ring. You don't want to be weak, so you want to get that right balance where you're disciplined, you get the weight down, but you don't lose that physical edge.
Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Here's what I like about David Haye. He puts his punches together. You see him holding on. Good shot to the head with that right hand.
Nice work.
A well placed overhand right. We're seeing a lot of big. Oh, banged around and down.
Joey has some choices to make. Two of them. One, do I get up? And two, how do I behave once I'm up?
Hey, you know how to play, though. You're pretty good, though.
David Haye's combination punching working out well there. He landed three solid shots. Good jab by David Haye. Chris Areola's showing you a little defensive skill there. Able to move away from that punch. He just looks exhausted. David Haye's accuracy is non-existent. This guy cannot punch a solid target right now.
No, but what this shows you, he's missing so many shots. We always think about the damage done when they land. This is showing you the damage that's done when they miss. You get discouraged.
End of the round there. The round in which we did see typically, how are they
just imagine you just walked into a room and somebody hit you from behind. You dropped. You're afraid to go in that room again.
So
put a light on in that room and explain to him why he got dropped.
I already owed him for the road. He was up in this damn fucking boxing mat and smoking me like a goddamn.
Zoning in on that gut combination punch downstairs. Oh,
damn.
What a shot upstairs.
He's going to have to grab on.
David Haye trying to get back in this round after being knocked down in the last round. 60 seconds in the in-round, Teddy. How much can really happen? How much can really benefit a fighter who's not down?
Well, how many times you gonna let him hit you with that haymaker like that?
Some cold water on top of the head where you revigorate him a little bit. You know, get his senses back a little bit. You have to talk to him. Once he calms down, once you physically get him back on track, you look to see if he's okay, and then you have to tell him why he got dropped to begin with.
Get in there, let's go.
He is damaged badly there. There it is! And he crashes through once again. He's
he throwing bazookas at you, bro.
What about this time?
Three.
You want me to get up for you?
Four. Five. Get to your feet.
He closed his eyes before he was.
And just know when you're getting up, keep this one up and then balance like this one. That always helped me.
Combo lands to the head.
Oh, shit. Who bleeding, me or you?
Something for his opponent after getting tagged.
Damn, Kraft is in the way.
Pace yourself.
That's not even what I clicked.
As we start round number four, it's clear to see that it's his precise punching that has earned him good grades on your scorecard, Teddy. With all that accuracy, clean, effective punching, he's up 3-0.
Yeah, I'm starting to wonder if he went to medical school because he's been a surgeon tonight.
And a strong offensive showcase, the combination by David Hay. Teddy, there are opportunities that are here for him, aren't there?
Yeah, counterpunch opportunities, because you got an opponent who's walking in a little bit. Now he has a chance to start to chuck something back at him a little.
1-2, 1-2.
Really a lot of consistency from him with the right hand. Chris Areola's got a way of just getting away from that punch. Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. Halfway through this round. What a big shot. David Hayes. This could be over soon, folks. And that does it. Unable to beat the count of 10. A knockout in the books. For the official particular, we send it up to
Ariola. Really bad, bro.
Ariola's finishing to his very. Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Teddy. Alongside Teddy Atlas. Good evening and welcome to the Mexico City Plaza here in Mexico City for our main event of the evening. 10 rounds of heavyweight between Chris Areola.
Damn!
He's unable to survive that shot. He's on the floor.
Oh my God!
Way through. through round number one. And he just turns that hook up top, and it does damage. Goes up top with the right hand. David Hayes taking a lot of punishment. Maybe too much punishment for an experienced referee like the one we have in there today to just keep on watching.
Well, you would expect him to be ready to do his job. Sometimes the job is to keep them fighting, you know, to make sure they break. Sometimes it's to stop the fight. I think it's that time now.
And he's trying to punch his way out of this damage he's incurred, but that's not the answer.
No, he's in a rainstorm. He needs an umbrella. And instead, he's running right out into the rain.
Areola's right hand scores well that time. Teddy, I don't think he's got vision to sticking around too long. He's landed power punches early.
Yeah, he wants to make it a quick night's work.
Shut up when you punch.
Right to the head with that right. Targeting each other, the exchange was something special. He has a new round in front of him, but I don't know that there's any new hope. He's been down numerous times tonight, including that last round.
You never know what a person is capable of when they're pushed in.
Big shot! He takes a big punch to bring down a big man like David Hayes.
Bro, he's gonna have head damage after this. That's who you just had. That's actually him. Yeah.
I wonder why he's looking like that.
Look bad. I'm going to get this dude. You know why we at the Mexican place? Let's fight there.
Everybody, glad you've made the decision to be with us alongside Teddy Atlas. Opening round scheduled for 10. Teddy, what do you look for early on when you're analyzing a fight of two power punchers facing off against each other that gives you a clue as to which way this is going?
Who's doing the little things a little bit better? Who's using the jab? Who's controlling range? Hey, who's thinking about it?
Man, George Foreman can take a punch. I can't do him like I did that other skinny motherfucker.
The books tonight. Here's the first. And a well-targeted combination by George Foreman. Well, a lot of people were looking forward to this fight, and with very good reason. When you pit these two guys together, it should be a very good fight.
You don't have to look, be the one of them. They are right there to be found, and our fans love that.
George Foreman's movement helped out there. He avoided that punch. Nice work, the left hand to the head. Areola's work in training camp is now paying off. Do you see the accuracy and the effectiveness with that combination? I like the way he went up top that time with the hook. You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. That's a shocker to see George Foreman. Big shot there. Big George Foreman not quite as dangerous when he's
that
laid out like that.
His overhand is ridiculous.
We got three already? God damn.
George Foreman wants to fight on. And here he comes. Very accurate with the overhand right.
Oh, no, that was just his set.
And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Chris Areola is impressing the judges and himself with that right hand. Foreman's almost looking foolish that time he missed so bad. Areola was putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination.
Who's bleeding?
fire with fire sometimes can work. But can it work under circumstances like this when a power puncher is going up against George Foreman?
Yeah, it can.
Oh! A batter to George Foreman. Now that's the way to overcome this.
Come on, man.
Keep holding the up button. Keep holding the up button. Even when you're up, keep holding it.
Seven, eight, nine, ten.
Yeah, see, you letting it go. You gotta keep.
Wow,
you gotta
that
keep
didn't take long. First round knockout. He's unable to beat the count.
I thought the beginning, Joe, came out a little cold, not much of a sweat, and that's what can happen when a guy comes out cold.
Let's find out how early into round number one it is with the official results. Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas welcoming you to London. Scheduled to go the full 10 if they get that far. Round one underway. George Foreman showing that he's got some defense of his own.
Yo, did you see his uppercut? You could have knocked me out with that.
Well, it's very easy. Oh, that's a big shot with the left hand. Look at that! And goes down from a big right hand.
He hit you twice. You see the other one? He hit you in the back of the head.
He turned his neck purple.
One, two.
See how they wanted you to hold it? That's why I say keep holding the up.
Foreman's still in a tough spot here. Don't get fooled just thinking he beat the count and everything's fine.
And I'm not so sure that it can grab. So what you gotta do now, if you're a trainer, the way you taught him in the gym is, you don't wanna go grab because you might leave yourself open. Move your head when it comes to you, then you grab him.
Oh, because you press an LB. LB is the push.
Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. He missed with that headshot. And coming upon the halfway mark of this 3-minute round.
Ooh.
Able to dismiss it. Good step back counter punch there. Foreman's knife down with a hook to the body. Crashes home with a hook. Wow! Yeah. And he goes down again. Will he get up from this?
There you go. Keep holding it up.
Six. Seven.
Come on.
Eight. Come on, man.
Damn, man.
I had it.
Yeah, they just got
that. Just
that
like
shit.
That,
real
it's over. Knockout in the first round.
I wish they had
well, he said that he starts with a lazy jab. The problem is, the other guy had a good, snappy right hand.
I wish he had a handicap.
We'll get to know you here in the opening round scheduled for 10. Foreman's well off the mark that time.
Nah, he's quick. That uppercut could have knocked me out.
Teddy, I've
that's
seen many times in your career,
I can't do that.
You were instructing that's a fighter that was going Foreman to face shit. A fighter who just had the longer reach, flat out had it. What did you tell him? What did you try to cement in his head leading up to that fight?
You know, sometimes you get caught up when you're fighting a fighter with those great, outstanding physical attributes like
big shot. How about that power shot? And how about the reaper that's going about a county away with Big George hitting the canvas?
I'm sitting there trying to change my stance.
George Foreman's rising back up. That takes some guts. Flush right hand to the head. How about that exchange? Right on the mark, double jab. Oh, that's gotta hurt. What a hurt to the body. And he is down and in bad shape.
Two, three, four, five.
It's all about,
big
it's all
George
about
George Foreman steadies himself and that 6'4" frame is back upright after the knockdown. Teddy. Areola's defense, is it ever good? Look at how easy he's able to block those punches. Last 10 seconds of this first round. Thought he had his target, but way off to the side with the uppercut. George Foreman's banged by a left hand. We come to the end of this round, and all you have to do is take a quick look at him to be able to say, boy, he's not in good shape. Now, Teddy, is it more important to handle the physical detriments and the damage that's been done to him or to pump him up mentally here at this point?
No, you have to be honest with yourself. You have to be realistic, and most important, you have to finish responsibility.
Foreman's damaged by a right hand. He's committed to that. Did you see that? From absolutely out of nowhere. Now on top of the world, he just caught him with that punch.
Short one, maybe 6 inches.
Come on, bro.
It's real fine.
7, 8, 9, 10. I was up.
Yeah, you almost
had it. Oh, man, come on.
The ref stops the fight. Damn. George Foreman is unable to get up and continue on.
I think you kind of got to slow it down and, like, kind of like.
They can't even see.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bob is probably going to mark that down as one of the highlights of his career. From
I thought that was Floyd Mayweather, but that's not it. The problem is we
all out for self in the world that's consumed by. Yeah, you want to play something else?
Yeah.
See what else I got?
Uh-oh. Let's see what you got, dog. Oof. Uh-oh, 2 items you want is on sale.
It's just in my...